Nobody wants to get united. Like, what we gotta do is meet everybody on 149th Street at the bench.
Hey guys, welcome back to the bench. Today I wanted to talk to you guys about the most useless spots we've all hit, assuming that you do graffiti illegally, and how graffiti in certain areas doesn't really seem to make much sense. Now, I'm sure some of you guys probably already know where I'm going with this, especially if you're a little bit more experienced in graffiti. But you see, I was driving around, I'm gonna be honest, I was getting ice cream because I love ice cream, but that's besides the point. And this ice cream place is in a really nice area. It's not a bad area by any means whatsoever. And across the street, there's some kind of like sports field with a little itty bitty building. And I'll draw this out for you so you can kind of envision this, I can kind of paint the picture for you. But one of the walls is facing directly at the street. Another wall is facing a little bit further away. It doesn't have as much view by the street. And somebody decided to do a throw up on the wall that's not facing the street. I thought that was weird. I was like, what? Why would you do it? I mean, look, if you're gonna do it anywhere, why would you do it there? Why? There's a perfectly good wall that's facing the street. Why wouldn't you hit that? Now, don't get me wrong. Here on the channel, I don't support doing illegal graffiti. I care about you guys, and I want to bring you guys value. I don't want to jeopardize your lives or inspire you in order to go ahead and potentially ruin your life. That's not what I'm here for. But the thought did cross my mind, if this dude's gonna risk his freedom, why would he risk it for that clearly worse spot? And then I look to my right, and there's another building where, once again, there is a prime, purely clean wall facing the street, and then there's a wall behind a fence, behind a dumpster that also faces the street, and it's behind a bunch of trees. And what wall did he hit? What wall would you hit? I don't know, tell me in the comments down below. This guy decided to hit the wall behind the dumpster, behind the fence, behind the trees. And after looking at this, I came to the conclusion that this is probably a newer graffiti artist, especially seeing based off his skill level. He was probably a little nervous and a little afraid. He didn't really want to go and risk all that much, but he still wanted to go out there and get his name up. And that's something I think most of us have been through at some point. And this also got me thinking about, well, this whole entire area is kind of useless to go ahead and hit. Graffiti doesn't really make much sense in every single area. You see, in a city, it makes sense in order to hit pretty much anything you possibly can because the population is higher, and as a result, there's more graffiti artists in the city. Someone is going to see it. But in a nice suburban area where nobody really goes to, you gotta start asking yourself the question, who are you getting up for? Because when you get up in order to go ahead and get your name out there, in order to get people to see it, but what people are seeing it? This type of mentality is something you also see in young graffiti artists that are still in high school. What happens with them? They take their markers and they're like, no, I'm gonna go bombing, and then they hit the high school bathroom thinking now that they're a king. Who's gonna see this? What graffiti artist, what real graffiti artist that matters is going to see this? Other than the janitor who hates his job, or your teachers who are sick and tired of children, those are really the only people that are gonna see that. And the same kind of mentality applies to small town graffiti, or like little suburban graffiti, where you see little tiny tags on stop signs, or you see throw-ups on buildings that make no sense. It's the same thing as the high school bathroom, just on a bigger scale. It's in a kind of useless spot where, once again, no one's really gonna see it, and there's not any other fish in your sea. The only other graffiti artist is gonna be another kid who thinks they're a graffiti artist, but really, for them, it's more of a phase. Now, all of this kind of reminds me of a little bit of a story back when I was being mentored by Demmer. There was a time where Demmer took me and my partner out to a restaurant. It was Olive Garden. I remember this very clearly. And me and my partner started grabbing our markers because, you know, we were like young toys. We wanted to go ahead and catch a tag in the Olive Garden. And Demmer legit looked at us and he was like, no, leave the markers behind. We're not hitting anything when we go here. Not only because Demmer loves the restaurant and doesn't want to get kicked out by me and my partner's foolishness, but also because, as Demmer stated, there are just some places where graffiti doesn't make much sense. Your efforts are better used elsewhere. And I feel like after I kind of grew older, I began to understand this concept a little bit more. Where the older you get, you stop taking unnecessary risks. You don't really want to go ahead and put your neck out for something that isn't going to give you as much of a return. And I think this just goes for life in general. I don't think this is exclusive to graffiti. So now you become a little bit more critical of the spots you hit, a little bit more understanding of where the value actually is. And if you're doing it in a nicer area that doesn't really make sense to do it in, then the chances of you getting arrested for a really useless wall goes up exponentially. And when you're a younger graffiti artist, this isn't something you really care about. So this leads me to go ahead and ask you guys, what kind of graffiti artist are you? So let me know in the comments down below, are you the kind of graffiti artist to hit high school bathrooms or just little suburban walls that nobody really cares about? You kind of work a little bit more with reckless abandon, or are you the type of graffiti artist that's a little bit more thought out as far as the spots you hit? You want calculated risks for spots that make sense. Or are you a legal only graffiti artist? If so, let us know why. That's kind of the camp I fall under. I used to do graffiti illegally. For those of you guys who are new here, I used to do it for quite some time. I was arrested twice, and nowadays I keep it 100% legal. But that pretty much wraps up today's video, guys. If you enjoyed it and you're new here, feel free to subscribe and become part of the smartest graffiti community anywhere online. We have the best how to do graffiti tutorials right here, and much more graffiti content here. I'll catch you guys next week. Until then, peace.